Good evening, and welcome along to a special edition of the Chilling Tales of Chelmsford, a collection of true stories about the darker side of our city. And today, our special edition is going to cover the witches of Chelmsford. The legislation of 1563 really did change some of the ladies' lives forever in Chelmsford. And one of the ladies was Elizabeth Lowes. She lived in Great Waltham, and she unfortunately became the first lady in the country to be convicted and hung for witchcraft. Being a witch could be a whole raft of things, from having the wrong type of friends to saying the wrong things, but the worst of all was to have a pet or an imp that could cause illness or even death. There was also three ladies out at Hatfield Peveril: Elizabeth Francis, Agnes Waterhouse, and the third was her daughter, Joan. The story really starts when Elizabeth Francis decided to hand over her cat, a white and black cat called Satan, who had magical powers, to Agnes. Agnes was keen to try out the powers of Satan, and she asked the cat to kill Widow Goody's cow, which he did. It all came to a head when William Finn took on an illness and later died. Agnes was found guilty and hung. She admitted to the crime so that her daughter Joan was not convicted, but Elizabeth Francis got away with a year's imprisonment. She did this twice further, and in 1579 she was finally hung for witchcraft.